my name is Donette Douglas. I'm the station manager here at WTJR Channel 16 in Quincy, Illinois, where we are working together till Jesus returns. Working together, that means you, us, area pastors, ministers, our volunteers, our staff and their family, we're all working together till Jesus returns. It takes every one of us. I thank you if you're a prayer warrior and you pray for WTJR. That means so much to us because we need those prayers and we feel your prayers. If you financially support WTJR, I say thank you. Many of you have been so faithful for so many years to be those that send those donation checks in on a regular basis. We say thank you. And those that guest on our programs, those that volunteer, we say thank you. It takes all of us. It's exciting that we can be the family of God and proclaim the gospel of Jesus Christ. We're proclaiming good news. Think about it. We're bringing hope into people's lives every single day. We encourage people in their walk with the Lord. And we also bring the gospel of Jesus Christ, which is salvation, which those that can come to know Jesus as Lord and Savior. The scripture says, whosoever calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved. And we're part of that, working together here at WTJR. Amen and amen. Well, we have some pictures from the last 2 weeks. Been a busy place around here. Amen. But we're so thankful that we can be busy for the Lord. Amen. Here we see the studio. We were getting all set up for Revive America. That's a monthly program we do live here in the studio. And you see Jeff and April Nye Davis. They are with Captivated Praise from Kokomo, Indiana. They were in the area and they brought the worship music. And the message was brought by evangelist Robert Newton. And Robert Newton is with Powerhouse Ministries out of Winfield, Iowa. And you just saw the monitors, some of the monitors. Here I am in production room on the switcher, and Brian was kind of observing. He also helped on the audio board, doing some training there. And then these are some of the people that came and actually were in the studio during the live program. We're live on Facebook and over the air, channel 16.1. There you see evangelist Robert Newton preaching, bringing a powerful, powerful message. Many people were touched. Many people were prayed for that night. And I know many people watched on Facebook, and that's exciting to see those numbers too. Amen. Then we taped some Pastor Speaks programs, and this is Pastor Violetta Beal, and she is with Broken Pots Ministry and also Jail Ministry for Jesus, and she lives in Macomb, Illinois, and she taped a Pastor Speaks program. And this is her husband, Rick Beal, and he taped a Pastor Speaks program also and talked a little bit about the jail ministry work and shared some good points, yes, for all of us to know about God's Word. So you want to be sure and watch those programs. And then Rick and Violetta taped an Outreach Connection program with Sherry McDaniel after lunch, talking about the Broken Pot Ministry and Jail Ministry for Jesus. A lot of good information. And then we taped a program also with Jerry Jenkins. He's in the middle there. He is founder of Addiction Free in Christ. Here on my left is John Eaton. He is part of the Addiction Free staff there. And then, of course, Sherry McDaniel, the host of Outreach Connection. They talked about a drug book that they have put together with a lot of information about drugs that people get addicted on. And I think you want to be sure and watch this program also. And then here's this picture of Pastor Gary Wallace. He hosts our live Pray 16 program on Fridays. It's good to have him back. He'd been on vacation. There we are in production room. And Pastor Keith, well, I should say missionary, Keith Garner was there. He was running the switcher. And again, a lot of monitors we watch. Our guest on the Pray 16 program was Dr. James Horvath. And he's from Rochelle, Illinois, with the Calvary Church there. And it was a powerful, powerful time of prayer, I'm telling you. And then we played one of the songs from Revive America, and that shows April Nye Davis singing. Here we had, just in the studio, as you can see, the different monitors and different shots we get in the studio. We want to thank George, our volunteer camera operator, directing them out in the studio. And we also taped Lightning Strikes with Pastor Paul Smith from Hamilton, Illinois, this last week. And then we had a guest in the studio. Tony Langley was here from CTN in Florida. And he is in the production room there with Jim Wilson, our engineer.
Master control.
Oh, that was the master control room. Yes, yes. Well, both rooms have a lot of monitors, so I looked at it very quickly. And there he is in the production room. And he was on the audio board helping with the taping of A Woman's Joy. Amen. Amen. Also taped two Women's Joy programs last week. And Sherry McDaniel was here, and we're continuing our discussion of the biblical meaning of love. So you'll want to watch those in a couple of weeks also. Okay, moving on. We got a lot. I'll tell you, it's getting busy. A lot of happenings around here. First, I want to talk about our newsletter. We just, the volunteers were here yesterday. We sent out the September newsletter. If you would like to have a newsletter, just contact us here at the station. You can go on our website, WTJR.org, and you will see the newsletter article. Also, there's a schedule on the back, which you can also get from our website. And then we'll notice that in the gray areas are the programs that have been changed for that month. So if you're interested in getting a newsletter, like I said, just contact us and we'll be glad to get one in the mail. Or you know what, better yet, why don't you just stop by the studio and pick one up? Then we get to meet you and we can pray with you. Amen? I'd love to do that. Amen. Okay, let's move on. WTJR HD Fund update. Yes. Drum roll. Hallelujah. We are at $6,170. Our goal is $20,000. I'm believing for that by the end of the year so we can start 2018 as an HD studio. This is a production upgrade with HD high definition with our switcher, cameras, and lighting. So to do that, we will need three cameras. And there you can see a picture of them. We'll need the stands, cables, tally light, remote, and various different parts that go with that. And that's $12,500 for that part of the upgrade. Also in the production room itself, we will need a switcher, recording equipment, because we're going to be going tapeless. That means we will be taping into a file that goes into the computer. Isn't that exciting? Who would have ever known? Years ago, we had them great big tapes. Remember, Jim? Them great big tapes. But also a character generator. We need that also. That's what we use to put people's names on the screen and other information. And lighting upgrade of about $1,000. So we need your help. As you can see, we're over a fourth of the way there. And you know, you've been so faithful through the years. Every time we've had a need, we show you the product, or I shouldn't say product, equipment that we need and the price, and you have always come through. And I believe you're going to come through in a big way this time also. So you can send your donations here to WTJR. And be sure, though, that you mark on it, it is for the HD fund, okay? Otherwise, it will be put into our regular expense account. And we appreciate that also. So thank you to all that have already sent in a donation. And just pray about what God would want you to do, okay? Amen. Prayer in the WTJR studio on Mondays at 1 p.m. We invite you to join us. And we love to pray for our country and our city, our loved ones, the church, each other. The prayer requests that come into WTJR, there's so much to pray for. And we love to have you come and join us here on Mondays at 1 p.m. If you yourself need prayer, please call us here at 228-1616. Or you can email your prayer request to pray16@wtjr.org. Also, I'd like you to call back in with your prayer request. I mean, praise reports. Yes, we like to hear the praise reports too. So again, you can call that same number. You can email to the same pray16@wtjr, and we'll put those praise reports on the air on Fridays too. Pray 16 is our live call-in prayer show on Fridays 11 a.m. to 12 noon. We repeat the program on Mondays at 9 p.m. And even though it's a repeat, we do have a phone operator, so you can still call with your prayer request and your praise reports. Yeah, there you go. Amen. I do want to let you know, we have a very special Praise 16 coming up, because I know a lot of you say, well, I work on Fridays at 11 a.m. I never get to watch it. Well, you can be a part of a live Praise 16 3-hour program. This will be on Saturday, September the 9th, from 7 p.m. to 10 p.m. You can call in. The numbers will be on the screen. The email's on the screen. And we have different pastors and their wives that will be hosting. And we want to stand in agreement with you. And you know what? You can pray and stand in agreement with us. Amen. So mark that on your calendar, Saturday, September 9th, 7 p.m. to 10 p.m., a special live, not only on WTJR, but on Facebook, call-in prayer show. Amen. Pray for America, a program hosted by Gary Schlockevier that's produced right here at WTJR. We have two special programs coming up in September. On Wednesday, September the 6th, we have program number one with Lyndall Shumate. Lyndall Shumate is a pastor. He is the founder of God's Harvesters ministry program in Hannibal. And he's also the House of Representatives for the 5th District in the state of Missouri. And he was on these two programs. They're different programs, okay? So program number one airs on Wednesday, September 6th at 8 p.m. And the second part of the program will air on Wednesday, September 20th at 8 p.m. And I know you'll enjoy those programs very much. Coming up also, we are going to show the Revive America that you've seen the pictures in the beginning of the program that was live here on August the 18th. We're going to show it on Saturday, September 2nd at 7 p.m. and on Sunday, September 3rd at 5:30 a.m. right here on WTJR. Also, I wanted to just kind of get some information out to you, because Christmas will be here before you know it. We are collecting shoeboxes, and we're joining with His Heart and Hands Ministry, Wild Olive Branch Ministries, and you see a picture of Kyle Kopp there. He's the one that will pick up the shoeboxes, and you need to have them here by Monday, November 27th. Be sure you mark on there if it's for a boy or girl and the age. We have other information and items that you can put in the shoeboxes. So give us a call. We can get you one of those sheets, or just call and we'll tell you what you can put in them, okay? Soul winning training here at WTJR. We use the soul winning script from the Great Awakening. If you're interested in training, just give us a call. We would love to give you personal training, or maybe a group or your Sunday school class or your church. We'll pray with you, we'll train, and we'll actually go out on the street with you and help you tell people about Jesus. Amen. Postage stamps, we're still collecting. You can either mail them or drop them here by the studio, 222 North 6th Street. We are on the second floor. There is a doorbell at the door, and you ring the doorbell, and we'll come down, and someone will come down and let you in. We are on the second floor. There's an elevator, so you can bring your stamps by, and we really appreciate it. Thank you. Coming up on A Woman's Joy this next week is the second part of the interview with April Nye Davis with Captivated Praise in Kokomo, Indiana. That will air on Tuesday at 9:30 a.m. and Friday at 9 p.m. Coming up on Outreach Connection this next week is Pastor Jerry Jenkins and John Eaton. And they are talking about the drug book that they put together and the work there at Addiction Free in Christ Ministry. And you can watch that on Monday, August 28th at 11 a.m., Wednesday, August 30th at 9 p.m., and Saturday, September 2nd at 5 p.m. Coming up on Pastor Speaks this next week is Minister Raymond Stedman. Now, Raymond attends Faith Assembly of God Church here in Quincy. He's part of a lot of prayer groups, and I know he helps different ministries. And he brought a message entitled, Being a Witness. And you can watch that on Sunday, August 27th at 2 p.m., Tuesday, August 29th at 1:30 p.m., and Wednesday, August 30th at 7:30 p.m. And our movie coming up on the family movie night is Last Flight Out. This is a Billy Graham movie. We have shown it before, but it's been a while. And I know you would really enjoy this. I've seen this movie. Very powerful message in it. And that will air on Saturday, September 2nd. I haven't got used to that yet. August is just about gone, isn't it? And Saturday, September 2nd at 8 p.m. And Sunday, September 3rd at 11:30 p.m. right here on WTJR. And Jim has a promo for you of this movie, Last Flight Out.
It's Anne. She's in trouble.
One missionary doctor in 1,000 square miles of jungle and no way out.
Why are you in this godforsaken place?
I told Dad I wasn't leaving, and sending you isn't going to change that.
Sometimes compassion comes with a price.
Not a good place to visit, sir.
She wanted to make a difference, but time was running out.
What happened?
Salazar. He burned the clinic and he took all the young men to work his fields.
I am beginning to lose my patience with you. This village will grow my crop, or else.
They believed in a dream, but were surrounded by a nightmare.
Stay quieto! No te muevas!
Sometimes the safe choice isn't a choice at all.
I'm a doctor. These people need me. I'm committed to them whether it's safe or not.
This is crazy. Take a look around.
There was only one option.
I can't leave you here.
You gotta have faith, Dan.
They're actually worried we're not gonna make it.
Worldwide Pictures presents a new action adventure, Last Flight Out. Now, in a modern-day story of sacrifice and redemption, one man discovers the price of freedom and the power of destiny.
You cannot hide in the jungle forever!
Hurry!
I'm it. I'm the last flight out.
Sometimes you need a second chance. Last Flight Out, a Worldwide Pictures release.
Again, that is Last Flight Out, and it will air on September the 2nd, that's a Saturday at 8 p.m., and Sunday, September the 3rd at 11:30 p.m. right here on WTJR. Amen. Well, I have just a few letters here, and I had written myself a note because one of the newsletter volunteers, like I said, they were here yesterday to fold and mail out the newsletters, said that she prayed over the newsletters. And we send out, in fact, this time we sent out 1,096 newsletters. She prayed over the newsletters that each one that received the newsletter would send in $1 for the HD fund so we could reach that fund real quick. And I told her, I'm just going to pass that on with the viewers because I think that's a great idea. If you haven't made a donation, you know, $1, well, for the 1,096, wow. That's $1,096. Wouldn't that be awesome? Though, praise God, praise God. I have a thank you card. This was from, says WTJR. Thank you for your love and kindness. I really appreciate the opportunities that you have given me to minister. May God greatly bless all of you and your ministry. And this was Justin Lehman, and he's youth pastor of a church out in Lycoms, Pennsylvania, and he was on Pastor Speaks this last week, and you've seen him a couple times on Pray 16, and he very much believes in prayer, and thank you for that. Thank you. From Quincy, Illinois, blessings your way. Thank you so very, very much. From Bonaparte, Iowa, thank you for the prayer alert for President Trump. It was last month in August, I sent out with the newsletter a prayer asking people to pray for President Trump, says, I am at a loss for words to express my admiration of you. Well, the Bible tells us that we are to pray for those kings and those in authority. So that's what we need to be doing. If God told us to do it, we need to do it. And so that's why I was encouraging everyone. And there were some different areas you could pray for the president in. And so I wanted to send it out and share it with the viewers. Amen. And this is an anonymous card, a note to say hello, beautiful tulips. I'd rather think of the tulips than the fall weather, although I know a lot of you love the fall and you can't wait for the golden colors and the leaves falling, but I like spring. And let you know you are on my mind. God bless you all from Quincy. And they put a donation in there, and I say thank you so very, very much. Appreciate those of you that take time, write us a little note, and it really does encourage us. Amen. Okay, now for our bridge today, and our bridge is a video spot that usually gives information either about something concerning WTJR or in the community. And we have the March for Jesus 2017 coming up here in Quincy on Saturday, September 30th. And so I want to show you this promo spot we've been airing on the news, and it's also on our Facebook page, and it's also on the March for Jesus Facebook page. So we want you to watch this now and get excited about it and get involved, okay? March for Jesus
2017. March for Jesus is coming soon, and you're invited. We'll meet at 9 a.m. at Morrison Plaza and the Playground Area at 12th and Main on Saturday, September 30th. The march will begin at 10 a.m. down Main Street. We'll cap it off with a huge celebration rally at Washington Park, featuring worship bands from the area. Join Christians from all across the tri-state area and lift up the name of Jesus at March for Jesus 2017.
Also, you can get information on WGCA's website. You can order t-shirts and hats that say, I, with a big heart, with the flames, love Jesus. This march is for Jesus. It's not about any specific denomination. It's about Jesus. It's just lifting high the name of Jesus. So we're coming together as the family of God to just lift high the name of Jesus. I'm excited about it. So mark that on your calendar. Get involved, okay? And if you'd like to be a part of the planning committee, on Tuesdays at 10:30 in the morning, we meet at WGCA Radio and have planning meetings. And you can be a part of that if you would like to be, okay? Okay, moving on. Thanking God for prayer. I am so thankful, and I've told you this many times, that I can talk to God. God is our Heavenly Father. God is the great I Am. He's the creator of all things. And yet He wants to spend time with us. Think about that. He wants to spend time with us. And we do that by, yes, praying. That's just talking to God. So I praise God for prayer and the hope that we have through Jesus Christ. And CTN, Christian Television Network, which we're affiliate of, we bring hope into homes all over the world every day. So I want to read the scripture today from Ephesians 3:20. And it says, now unto him that is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we ask or think, according to the power that worketh in us. He can do far more than we can even imagine. You know, we make God small and put him in a box sometimes, but he's big. And nothing's impossible with him. I've been sharing with you, and this is our last devotion from the Daily Bread series, Prayer Changes Things. And the main scripture or idea at the bottom of the page, I should say, is when God says no to our request, we can be sure it's for the best. When God says no, we can be sure it's for the best. And it's entitled, Surprised by God. After 10 years of renting in a charming location, we discovered that our landlord suddenly needed to sell the house. I ask God to change the circumstances and make it possible for my wife and me to stay in this place we'd made home, where we've watched our children grow up, but God said no. When it comes to my needs, I worry that I'm asking for the wrong thing or that I'm not worthy of the request I'm making. But God, no, doesn't need to shake our faith when we're grounded. Surrounded, I like to say, in His love. In Ephesians 3, Paul understood that those who know the love of Christ intimately, that means you have a personal relationship, you spend time with Him every day, praying in His Word and fellowshipping with other believers. We can trust God to have a loving reason for saying no. Shortly after hearing no from God about my request, friends from church offered to rent us a home they were vacating. Our new location, with new appliances, new plumbing, new electrical wiring, and an extra bedroom, sits on the ocean. An idyllic scene of ships, sails, and sounds that daily remind us that God is bigger than any issue we face. Our loving Father used loving friends to give more than we ask. Whether God gives us more than we imagined or far less than we deserved, we can trust that His plans are much better than ours. In Ephesians 3:14-21, we read, "When I think of all this, I fall to my knees and pray to the Father, the Creator of everything in heaven and on earth. I pray that from His glorious, unlimited resources, He will empower you with inner strength through His Spirit. Then Christ will make His home in your hearts as you trust in Him. Your roots will grow deep into God's love and keep you strong. And may you have the power to understand, as all God's people should, how wide, how long, how high, and how deep His love is. May you experience the love of Christ, though it is too great to fully understand. Then you will be made complete with all the fullness of life and power that comes from God. Now all glory to God, who is able through His mighty power at work within us to accomplish infinitely more than we might ask or think. Glory to Him in the church and in Christ Jesus through all generations, forever and ever. Amen." And you know, you could pray that as a prayer over someone. I've done that. I've shared some of these scriptures with others as I prayed for them. I have some friends, John and Bonnie Furness. John hosts Simple Truth here on WTJR. They're part of Living Water Ministries out of Haiti. And they were sharing with me this great praise report. They go to Haiti, the pastor there they work with. They had built churches, they've built schools. And his desire was to have a radio station. So they started praying for the radio station and asking God for 1 million people. Well, God gave them a radio station, but He gave them 2 million people to be able to listen to that station. And when I heard that, I knew I don't ask big enough of God. God is a big God. He loves us and He wants to bless us. So ask big of God and then thank Him for the answer.
CTN Inside Report with founder and president Bob DeAndre.
Hello again, friends. Well, if you've been watching any of these this week, you're just having a love fest, aren't you? 1 Peter 1:22 says, "Since you have purified your souls in obeying the truth through the